Rugby is a rough game similar to football, believed to have been developed at England's rugby school early in the 1800s. In 1823, when William Webb Ellis caught the ball during a game of soccer at rugby school, he ran with it, forever changing the game and leading the way to an entirely new sport.
Friends on the guys' team was just like really kind of just drove us, like they all wanted us to, and it was just we were in talking to the coach and everything. It just seemed like a really fun thing to do.
So I think that one big difference between like the boys and the girls is the fact that they have four coaches and we only have one coach that we just got within last week, and we are going to Ireland next week, so it was kind of like a last minute thing. He's been coaching us. We do have a game today, but we're playing after all the boys, so it's kind of like
action.
So for a while there, we like didn't even have our own field to play on, and so we were kind of sharing with the boys, but we only got like 10 yards, and then they would kick us off after like 20 minutes. And now that we're like outside, we still only get like a small little portion of the field. And, I don't know, it's kind of hard to work at things as like a team when you only have a certain amount of field, and it's just, they like to kick us off. Like to invade our area.
There's a difference between the girls and guys team, just because it's just so different to have a girl play rugby. I'm sure with our season going on, it's hard to get a coach to coach the girls. And I know some frustration builds there, but we try to calm it down as much as we can.
Yeah.
And then signing for college. I can't explain it. It's something that I'm grateful to have. I didn't think I was going to get it, but lucky enough with my coaches and my team, they supported me and I was able to achieve that goal. Thank you.
I started the Superior Rugby Club in 2008 with a 5- and 6-year-old. And each year we've just added a new team as more players have come in. So we started the high school team 4 years. This is our fourth year. So I've been coaching since 2008. As far as starting a girls team, it's a little more challenging as a male coach, because there's certain things that you have to do and demonstrate that it makes it a little bit harder. So getting a girls coach is tough if we want to get just a female coach. Overall though, girls are, it's a good team, and they're very energetic. They're just as eager as the guys to play. They're just as eager to get out to practice and practice more. So overall, I'd say it's about the same, except for trying to get a coach.
So the girls are treated like rugby players, just like the guys are. The girls club has 15 plus, the guys club has 60 plus, so the space and equipment gets delegated as it needs to be. But one of the greatest things about rugby is that everyone's equal and everyone's the same, whether you're a man or a woman, whether you're a D1 player, a D4 player, whether you're the best player on the field or the worst player on the field. Everyone gets treated exactly the same, and I hope all of my girls say that same thing. I myself am a coach at the University of Colorado, where they have a plethora of available coaches, especially since it's the off season for us. It's not our full season. So I had the opportunity to come here and help out, help with the girls. I guess they did not have enough coaches to be able to throw one over from the boys' side. So I came in and I'm super grateful for it because it's just a great experience. These girls are fantastic. They all play very, very hard, and they're all going to be great rugby players one day.
Monarch has two rugby teams. The boys team was founded a few years ago and the girls team was just started this year. As you can see in these two pictures, the boys have a bigger crowd with more fans to support them than the girls do.